soup kitchen in Berdichev has been providing tasty dinners to needy people during 15 years. Our social services cannot find resources to cover needs of all poor people. Therefore, friends and sponsors worldwide and charitable foundation House of Bread are looking for ways to help underprivileged. 23 years of independence after the collapse of the USSR made no difference in social and economic spheres, which are far from European standards. Pensioners, disabled and diseased people, orphans and lonely ones are the most vulnerable to poverty and isolation. For the most of them, the only meal per day is a dinner in the soup kitchen. Yet many disabled people never leave their apartments and are delivered food by social and food kitchen workers. 15 years have been passing in this mode. But here comes another test for Ukraine. Revolution. Maidan. And war. Followed by terrible consequences. Death, destruction, famine, and refugees. In a moment, people became destitute, homeless, jobless. We've heard the word refugees many times, but it was somewhere else, in Syria, in Central Africa, in South Sudan. But all of a sudden, Ukraine was added to the list of these countries. And the concept refugee became a real person who is here, at hand. They took only things they could carry and fled their homes with children. Now they need food, housing, money. We got acquainted with several families from the East, examined their living conditions, took an inside look at their problems. Some of them tell about their lives the following. Every time car exhausts, I hear shooting instead. It's terrible. Several times, planes were crashed over our house, and we were eyewitnesses. We've seen people falling down and thought they were parachutists. There are no words to describe this nightmare. This family, 9 persons, found refuge in an empty house provided by some good people. Older children went to school, but preschoolers stay at home. Since parents have no work, they run out of money. So, in Berdichev soup kitchen, the families provided food. Today, 50 refugees are supported there. We have interviewed some of them. Stepanets Olga Grigorievna, I came to Berdichev with my parents and 2 children from Donetsk. We've come here because of hostilities in our region. We are homeless. We had to quit jobs, leave houses. This place is safe. We live here in a house with other refugees, like a large family. We were given dinners. Here we eat. Household, job, We had to leave everything, because life there is impossible. Bombs, shooting, murders are there. Tura Yulia Vitalievna, we've also come from Donetsk region, Makeyevka city. We had to quit jobs and studies. My husband, two children and I live with Olga like a good family. We eat here. We are thankful for this support. My name is Chernyshyva Inna. I came from Lugansk region, Severodonetsk city area, Pavlograd village. Lysychansk city, which was nearby, is almost destroyed now. Our area was also shelled. One house next to ours was totally ruined. Besides, during shelling, a bridge and 35 meters of railroad tracks were wrecked. Gas pipe was damaged, and we were left without gas and water. My family is large. My husband is a pastor, and we have 5 children. 3 boys go to school, and 2 kids go to kindergarten here. Just recently, my husband returned from that area. He heard shots there, so it is still not safe to move back. There is no work in our home area. This is another family that moved from Makeyevka, Donetsk region. Makeyevka is so dangerous and not a safe place for my 3 children, so we moved here. 3 months have passed. City authorities provide no support. I'm thankful to church for clothing. I'm thankful for the food we get. It can be a trifle for one, but it is a great support for us, because now we are trying to save money. Here we must rent an apartment. Social services, where I addressed, could provide us a dormitory without toilet and bathroom. My older child passed 2 surgeries: intestinal perforation and peritonitis. So we cannot live in unsanitary living conditions. We cover rent expenses by ourselves. This morning I was hoping to buy milk for my babies, but I still have no child assistance payment and cannot afford this baby food. The payment is delayed since August 15th. We came from Mariupol. We've had an apartment and work until the warfare started. Our child was frightened every time he heard shooting. So we have picked up all we could take and came to Zhytomyr. It is a safe place for us, but we have faced other problems. We have no place to live, and we cannot find a job here. In order to be employed, we must have local registration. So there are no results until this day. As you could see, all these people are united by similar problems. They need water, food, clothing, finances, and human attention. we have a saying, many a little make a meagle. On behalf of all these people, from our deepest heart, we thank all of you who united efforts to help people who suffered during hostility in Ukraine. May the Lord reward you and multiply your fruits. This story, we want to end up with a wish from all refugees in Ukraine. We are waiting for peace and really want to go home. Hope we will see it in the nearest future.